This poem is called Dragon Country to Jacob Bermey. It's based on a line I encountered many years ago in Law's translation of Bermey. The poem is in quatrains, rhyming A-B-A-B, roughly iambic pentameter. This is the dragon's country, and these his own streams. The slime on the railroad rails is where he has crossed the track. On a frosty morning, that field mist is where his great turd steams. And there are those who have gone forth and not come back. I was only a boy when Jack Sims reported the first depredation. What something had done to his hog pen. They called him a goddamn liar. Then said it must be a bear, after some had viewed the location, with fence rails like matchwood splintered, and earth a bloody mire. What no bear had been seen in the county in 50 years, they knew. It was something to say, merely that, for people compelled to explain what, standing in natural daylight, they agreed couldn't be true. And saying the words, a man felt in the chest a constrictive pain. At least, some admitted this later, when things had got to the worst, when, for instance, they found in the woods the wagon turned on its side, mules torn from trace chains, and you saw how the harness had burst. Spectators averted the face from the spot where the teamster had died. But that was long back in my youth, just the first of case after case. The great hunts fizzled. You followed the track of disrepair, ruined fence, blood smear, brush broken, but came in the end to a place with weed unbent, leaf calm, and nothing, nothing was there. So what in God's name could men think when they couldn't bring to bay that belly-dragging earth evil, but found that it took to air? 30-30 or buckshot might fail, but then at least you could say you had faced it, assuming, of course, that you had survived the affair. We were promised troops, the guard, but the governor's skin got thin when up in New York the papers called him St. George of Kentucky. Yes, even the Louisville reporters who came to Todd County would grin. Reporters, though rarely, still come. No one talks. They think it unlucky. Things happen, but they are denied, as when on the road to go out to the old Pinchum Church, a salesman, traveling for Swift or Armour, stepped from his car. The sheriff said, accident caused by a blowout. They burned up the car to explain lack of patronage for the embalmer. If a man disappears, well, the fact is something to hide. The family says gone to Akron or up to Ford in Detroit. When we found Jeb Johnson's boot with the leg, what was left, inside, his mother said, no, it's not his, so we took it out to destroy it. Land values are falling. No longer do lovers in moonlight go. The rabbit, thoughtless of air gun, in the nearest pasture cavorts. Now certain fields go untended. The local birth rate goes low. The coon dips his little black paw in the riffle where he nightly resorts. Yes, other sections have problems somewhat different from ours. Their crops may fail, bank rates rise, on rumor of war, loans be called. But we feel removed from the news of Russia or other great powers, and from much ordinary hope are now disenthralled. The Catholics have sent in a mission. Baptists report new attendance. But that's not the point. We are human, and the human heart demands language for reality that has no slightest dependence on desire or need. Now in church they pray only that evil depart. But if the beast were withdrawn now, life might dwindle again to the ennui, the pleasure and night sweat known in the time before, necessity of truth had trodden the land and heart to pain, and left in darkness the fearful glimmer of joy, like a spore